This is Matthew from Blue Matador, the Alert Automation Service. In another video, I laid out the 7 critical metrics you should monitor to know when to scale your database cluster. This video will focus on DB connections. Let's start with the limitations on the DB connections. Even though it's not reported by CloudWatch, and there's no visual indication on any graph, RDS databases have limits on the number of active connections they will allow. Most connections will come from your application, but they can also come from cron jobs or DB admins. Each server in a cluster has its own limitation on DB connections, which can be adjusted independently of any other server in the cluster. The defaults come from Amazon and depend on the amount of memory available for each server. For example, the default limit on a T2 small is 45 connections, and it's 1,000 for an R4.large. Now let's see what happens when you use all the available database connections. I have a PHP script to open as many connections as possible to my RDS instance. Once there's a failure, we'll see how many it created and the reason for failure. Here we go. When the maximum number of connections has been reached, all new connection requests are rejected. You'll be able to see the DB connections in CloudWatch, though there's no indication of any limitations on the metric. One way to keep up with the limitation is by setting a CloudWatch alarm, which we'll do in a second. Another way is to use Blue Matador, which will manage these types of thresholds for you. Maxing out the number of DB connections could be due to a bug, a recent feature release, a new service or more servers, a configuration change related to connection pooling, a spike in traffic, or growth in demand for your application. At this point, you could fix the problem via code change, adding more readers, or by increasing the size of your RDS instance. My point is that it's a lot easier to do these things if you know why the application is breaking in the first place. So let's create an alarm for DB connections on my server. Because I have 2 servers, I'll need 2 different alarms. If I add any more servers, I would need to remember to add more alarms. Navigating the interface is easy. Selecting the appropriate threshold and options is a little harder. I already have an SNS topic to send to. Watch my other videos for help on creating that. The metric is DB connections, and we want to monitor the maximum. This first server is a T3.small and has a limit of 45 connections. I'll set the threshold for 40 connections in any given minute. I may get notifications before I actually run out of connections, but that's the point. Creating the other alarm is similar, except this server is a T3 medium, which has a limit of 90 connections. I'll adjust the threshold appropriately. Now the huge caveat, you're not done. If you ever add servers, you'll need to remember to add more alarms. If you ever change the size of your servers, you'll need to change the alarms. If you ever override the parameter groups to allow more connections, you'll need to remember to update the alarms. And that's it. Keep an eye on your database connections to stay on top of RDS scaling. Thanks for watching. If you'd rather not spend time on alarms, thresholds, and notifications, try Blue Matador, the Alert Automation Service. Also, make sure you subscribe to our channel for more videos.